eyes water for no apparent reason? In this video, I'm gonna talk about the top 5 conditions that may cause your eyes to water and what you can do about it. Let's focus in. Hey, howdy everybody, I'm Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. Eye Guy, with the show that focuses on keeping your eyes the healthiest and your vision the clearest. I make a video every week to give you the tips, tricks, and tools to keeping your eyes the best. If that's something you're interested in, subscribe so you don't miss any future videos. Otherwise, let's focus on those weeping eyes. Now, these are the top 5 most common conditions that I see in the clinic that may cause your eyes to water. There's about 1 million different causes, but these are the top 5 most common. Number 1 is dry eyes. Now, usually when I see a patient and they tell me that their eyes have been watering, and then I tell them right back, hey, your eyes are dry, they look at me like I'm a crazy loony bin and that I didn't even listen to a word that they said. But it's true, sometimes eyes watering, or that watery eye, is a protective mechanism that kicks in when your eyes may be dry. Your eyes are dry, it sends the message back to the brain responds by flooding the tears under the eyes to compensate. And a lot of times, it's more tears than the eyes can handle, and they'll tend to weep off the side, causing you to want to wipe away the tears a lot. One thing that I see associated with this dry eye in the clinic is a lot of times people will get something called keratitis, or inflammation of the cornea right on the surface of the eye. It's pretty much little versions of dry patches. A lot of times what I say is sometimes you'll get these dry patches on your hands if your hands are really dry, and you'll go to put lotion on them. Same thing on the eye. You can get dry patches on the surface of the eye, and your eyes and brain will want to compensate by dumping more tears onto there to coat the cracks and dry patches of that eye. Now, unfortunately, dry eyes can be very complicated to treat because there's a lot of different reasons, a lot of different conditions and root causes to dry eye that sometimes can be overwhelming at what treatment will work the best for you. Now, as a baseline, when you're talking about dry eyes, you wanna be drinking enough water, plenty of water. You do wanna be using those over-the-counter artificial tears. Like I said, if you get dry patches on your knuckles, you wanna put lotion on there. If you get dry patches on your eyes, you wanna put artificial tears on there. Further things that you can do is definitely make sure that you're up on your omega-3s, even if it's omega-3 supplements, eating your fish, if you want to eat fish. You can use a humidifier to make sure that the air around you is nice and moist. Now, I plan on making future videos about dry eyes that goes more into depth about certain dry eye conditions and treatments, so make sure you're subscribed for that in the future. Number 2 is allergies. Now, what's tricky about this is some people may not even notice that they have allergies that are causing their eyes to water. They might not have the runny nose or sneezing or the typical allergy symptoms, but they might have just a little low-grade allergy, just enough to irritate the eyes and make the eyes water. Now, in the clinic, a lot of times I'll pull people's eyelids down, and on the inside of the eyelids, you'll have these tiny little bumps called papillae that will show up if you're experiencing any allergies. And these little bumps will secrete the chemical histamine that can make your eyes red and itchy, and also cause some inflammation, which will eventually lead the eyes to water. So for this one, the best thing you can do is try and avoid the allergen if you know what the allergen is. Sometimes people don't even know what is irritating their eyes. If you don't know what the allergen is, the best thing you can do is get your hands on an allergy eye drop. There are really good over-the-counter allergy eye drops. The best one for me that I usually recommend to patients is called Pataday. And I'll put a link down below so you can check that out, but works really well. They have one drop versions where you can just put a drop in the morning, works throughout the day. Also, 2 drop a day, so morning and night, also works really well. Number 3 is something called blepharitis. Blepharitis is the inflammation of the eyelids. You'll specifically see this inflammation right around the base of the eyelashes. In fact, a lot of times you can see a lot of flakes or gunk that are built up on the base of the eyelashes. And this may cause the rim or the margin of the eyelid to get red and inflamed and irritated. Now, sometimes if you have those flakes, the flakes themselves will fall into the eye and cause the eyes to be irritated and water. Now, the chronic condition of this blepharitis is you have bacteria that are sitting right on the base of the eyelashes, and they'll produce these toxins. And these toxins, bacteria poop, will sit on the surface of the eyelashes, eyelids, and a lot of the toxins will get on the surface of the eye. This will in turn cause the eyelids to become more inflamed, more red, make the eye more irritated, more inflamed, and make the eye water. Blepharitis can actually be a chronic cycle, and it's sometimes really tricky to break the cycle and treat. Now, the baseline there, is you want to be able to keep your eyelids and eyelashes as clean as possible. Sometimes you'll have doctors that will recommend applying baby shampoo to actually wash your eyelashes. What I found that works the best for home maintenance of blepharitis is actually to clean the eyelids with specific blepharitis or eyelid wipes. Probably the most common one that you'll see out there is called OcuSoft. And really simple, if you can do it twice a day, the better, but at least at nighttime, go in and clean your eyelids and your eyelashes out, really clean down to the margin. And you can even go up further up to the eyebrow just to try and get all those flakes off, any bacteria or allergens that got caught into the eyelashes. If you can keep those clean, then you'll have the best chance of breaking the cycle of this blepharitis. Hey, if you're finding value out of this video, hit that like button for me. By hitting the like button, it tells YouTube that these videos are actually working and helping people. So kind of do me a favor, hit that like button for me. Okay, number four that I see in the clinic is a blocked tear duct. Now we have little tiny opening holes in the inside corner of our eyelids called puncta. The puncta is actually what drains the tears out of our eye. And if you can imagine, if you have a blocked tear duct or a blocked drain, then tears will not flow down that drain. Instead, they'll be forced out the side of the eye or down the middle. Now, a lot of you can relate to this that have kids. A really common thing that you'll see in infants, newborn babies, is they'll have a blocked tear duct and they'll constantly get this buildup of tears in the corner of their eyes. Sometimes there'll be a slight infection in there with some gunk and mucus in there. And it's just because that tear duct is blocked in there and it's not allowing tears to kind of flow and flush the eye out. So if you're experiencing something like this, the best thing you can do is actually massage the drainage tube that's on the corner of the eye. If you can get right into the corner of the eye and kind of massage it, especially if you can apply heat a little bit, that will allow or hopefully move any kind of drainage that's in the corner of that eye or the drainage tube down there and kind of help it flush it out. Now, sometimes people might get an infection in there, may need or may require an antibiotic, an ointment, or a drop that can help clear that infection that's in the puncta. Now, sometimes you can just be born with a narrow tubing or a narrow drain, and so you'll have eyes that water for no apparent reason. Maybe it's just because you have a narrow drain that can't handle all of your tears on your eye. Now there's something that's called punctal irrigation where we can actually squirt saline solution through that drainage to try and get rid of whatever block might be there that's holding up all the tears. Number five that I usually see in the clinic is general problems with the eyelids themselves. Now the eyelids play a vital role in keeping your tears on your eyes, moving them in the right direction. If you have something wrong with the eyelids, they droop, they don't sit right up on the eyeball, then your eyelids won't be able to do their job in moving the tears in the right place. Now there's something called ectropion where the eyelid, the bottom eyelid, may droop out a little bit, may get loose and lax and droop out. Now I said before, there's little drainage holes on the inside corner of that eyelid, and if that eyelid is drooped out, the tears won't find that drain and instead will leak out the side of the eyelids on the other side. Now on the flip side, there's something called entropion where the eyelids will actually curl into the eye. And what happens there is sometimes the eyelashes on the eyelid will be pointing in towards the eyeball and kind of rub and scrape and poke on the eye, causing it to be irritated and causing that reflex tearing to happen, causing your eyes to water. Another thing, if you have just really lax lids or maybe not blink the whole way, sometimes if you only do this half blink, you'll get a section of the eye that's just constantly exposed to the air and will dry out really quickly. Now, if you have that dryness of the eye, it'll cause the eyes to water. Now, you can concentrate on doing eyelid blink exercises. There's actually eyelid blink exercises out there. It does help some people. Kind of funny to tell people to, you know, work on exercising their eyelid blinks, but they are out there to kind of keep your eyes blinked to coat the whole eye. With entropion, where the eyelashes are rubbing on the eye, you can actually go in there and pluck the eyelashes out to reduce the eye watering. You can also, if it's really bad, you can get those eyelash follicles destroyed so it doesn't grow any more eyelashes. With ectropion, where the eyelid is drooped out, a lot of times you're gonna need surgery to bring that eyelid back up onto the surface of the eyeball. There's about a billion different things that may cause the eyes to water. I could literally make this list with 100 things on it, but this video would have been 2 hours long. But these are the top 5 things that I see in the clinic. Honorable mentions would be obviously foreign body, if there's something in the eye, cause your eyes to water. conjunctivitis, pink eye will usually make your eyes water. And then obviously there's a lot of normal things that may cause your eyes to water. Cutting onions, those onions chemicals will spark your eyes to water. Yawning can stimulate the nerve that causes your eyes to produce some tears and flood the eyes with tears. If you're having eye watering and not sure exactly what is causing it, it's just best to go in and see your eye doctor. He'll be able to tell you exactly what may be causing your eyes to water and what you can do about it. Hey, thanks for watching the video, everybody. Comment below if you've had any experiences with these random episodes of eye watering. And again, I'm Dr. Eye Guy, committed to looking out for you and your eyes. Stay focused, and I'll see you in the next video.